In South Africa, we eat food just because it's delicious. And I thought things in China would be the same as in South Africa before I came here. I know Chongqing is an amazing city and is famous for spicy food. After 17 days in Chongqing, I realized that the city consists of three main flavors: the taste of nature, the taste of history, and the taste of life. Chongqing is settled at the southwest part of China. The city was built on mountain ranges and people live beside the river. It always rains in Chongqing. There's a line from an ancient poem that goes like this: "During autumn, the rain falls at night and fills the pools of Chongqing." This is exactly what Chongqing is like. Some traditional Chinese doctors told me this place is filled with Xi Qi. Usually, they regard the body as an ecosystem. Our bones compare to the rocks, our blood flows like the rivers, and our qi is like the wind. They compare the flow of qi and blood to the cycles of water and air. It's balanced and intertwined. Once the balance is broken, people can easily fall ill. It is what the Chinese call the imbalance of qi and blood. Chinese also have another saying which suggests that food and medicine come from the same source. Food, rather than medicine, is used to nurse health by the Chinese. As Xi Qi prevails in Chongqing, it is likely to accumulate in the human body, and this may cause rheumatism. In order to get rid of Xi Qi, Chongqing people eat spicy food. That is why they have spicy hot pot.
大家好，我叫朱江，来自重庆。重庆呢是挨着长江水边边上建立的一个城市，所以说呢，船运在重庆来说是一个比较发达的一个运输的一个行业。川江号子呢，经过一天辛苦的工作之后，就在长江边上，像这样架着一个锅，然后把富人家不要的流下水 和留下肚以及其他的一些流杂碎放在锅里面，倒上水，倒一点点油，加点辣椒、花椒、生姜、大蒜在里面，把其他的一些流杂碎啊、流下水啊、流下肚放在里面一煮。这一张照片就是体现了在抗日战争时期重庆人吃火锅的一个场景当时用的炉子呢还是这种篱笆、铁丝网那种敷的那种像陶瓷罐那种。 然后这边呢，有一个当时吃火锅的一个模拟的现场图，这是锅，锅很小，因为就是一个人吃或者两三个人吃，锅很小，没有现在的锅这么大。那这里呢，就是我们重庆在70年代到90年代，重庆火锅进入了一个非常非常快速的一个发展的一个阶段。 在70年代，我们的火锅呢就已经可以登堂入室了，就是放在台面上。这样一个小锅里面就是涮的是荤菜，比如说毛肚、鸭肠这些就可以放在上面。这个小锅里面呢，我们可以煮点青菜，煮点清汤也可以，或者你在小锅里面煮红汤，边边上煮清汤也可以，这个就是看个人爱好不一样。 火锅在明代末、清代初的时候开始慢慢的一个蓬勃发展，然后在清代中期的时候，火锅就已经进入了皇室里边，俗称千手宴，就是皇帝宴请宾客、宴请文武大臣，吃饭的时候摆了1000桌火锅，所以说俗称就是千手宴。
我们那个冬子火锅儿，也就叫洞庭火锅儿，是在两路口儿那届是远近闻名的，在全重庆的话哈。我们那火锅儿呢，从1989年底就开到现在，至今都是29年了。最开始我们搞那个冻子火锅的事儿呢，哈，是因为我们那个冻子里面是储藏的咸咸菜，就是咸菜嘛，哈。因为那个冻子里面呢，哈，藏咸菜呀，应该是保鲜。后头嘛，因为，经过改革开放嘛，89年底，那个冻子啊就没得好大用处的了。没得好大用处的了，我们单位啊都决定把那个洞子啊都开发出来，都承包给我们个人。我都那个时候呢，89年底都下海了，都响应那个改革开放搞活嘛，都利用那个洞子啊做起了火锅儿。刚开始做的时候，那个洞子里面环境条件很差，烧煤油炉子，那个煤油炉子啊烧起来烟熏火燎的，眼睛抽得很。一进去吃火锅的时候，眼睛都是要抽出眼睛水来。还有啊，空气也相当的污染。但是啊，由于洞子里头啊是一个奇特的那个独特的一种环境嘛，哈，好，那些食客们都很乐意在洞子里面来。它有一种独特的那个气候嘛，都是冬暖夏凉。夏天家在里面吃，感觉到比较凉快；冬天家就比外头的温度啊要高个10多度嘛，哈，再加上我们自己的努力哈，味道呢是自己调制的。火锅里的辣椒能够散寒、除风发汗、去冷皮、行痰；花椒和麻椒能够坚持明目、除湿止痛、解心降压；老姜能够发汗、温中、止呕、止咳。大枣、牛油等佐料也都是滋补壮阳的，所以吃火锅儿对我们身体有不少好处，所以说那些客人都很喜欢。
又来了。
我要一个嘛。
Chinese people obey the law of nature. Ancient Chinese regard the unity of the body and nature as the highest level of life. That's what I've learned from China. The unique features of the local environment bestow special characteristics on its inhabitants. We ask nature for food, enjoy the beauty of taste, and build our own lifestyle in this process. This is how we are closely connected to the environment.